A hostess makes good on its threat to shut down. Now thousands are out of work, including many here in Maine. Good evening and thanks for joining us tonight. I'm Tracy Sable, claiming the company does not have the financial resources to survive the ongoing nationwide baker's strike. Hostess has asked a federal bankruptcy court for permission to cease operations. Live at 6, News 8 Steve Minich joins us from outside the Hostess plant in Biddeford, where 500 workers no longer have a job. Steve?
Well, Tracy, as you can see behind me, despite the company's announcement today, several of those workers are still here, and they vow to stay here over the weekend. But even as they continue walking the picket line, reality is they need to figure out what's next.
We're going to stay here. We have a trust issue with this company.
They're not convinced the company is really shutting down. So to make sure Hostess doesn't attempt to reopen with replacement workers, they're standing firm.
We have to make sure that everything is closed down. We don't want one person inside that bakery.
But if in fact the bakery does close down, most of these workers are quick to admit long term, they're not sure what'll be next.
You know, we'll have to move on, do re-education, and hopefully the economy will pick up and more jobs will be out there for us.
For the short term, however, Maine's Department of Labor says it is weighing all factors in the parent company's shutdown. But usually it says striking workers are not eligible for unemployment benefits, though non-striking and non-union members are. And to help prepare the laid-off workers, the department, working closely with city officials, has already mobilized its career centers and rapid response team.
Unemployment compensation, where do you go from here, retraining, the whole scope of things that will be most on the minds of those workers who are suddenly displaced.
Biddeford's mayor says he's confident this bakery won't stay closed for long.
What we have here is a facility that is essentially state-of-the-art.
With a workforce that's ready to step right back inside if, in fact, a new company does decide to buy it.
All right, management sold separately.
Now our next step is to hope that somebody who wants to make some dough come in and do it. You know, we're looking for some good management. We're turnkey, we're ready to rock.
By the way, the Labor Department's rapid response team is scheduled to begin talking and meeting with workers here as soon as this Monday. Live in Biddeford, Steve Minich, News 8.